Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you, Mr. Ranking Member. And I want to thank all of our witnesses today, particularly Dr. Fauci, who was born in the great city of New York, in the beautiful borough of Brooklyn. New Yorkers are very proud that you were a New York raised and New York doctor before you became America's doctor. And I must say that, as the chairman mentioned, when we had our hearing on March 11th, which I was privileged to chair, when I asked you how is it going to go, you said it's going to get worse and worse and worse. And the next day, everybody started closing down, sports clubs, museums, and treating it with the seriousness that disease had to be treated with. And at that hearing, when asked about testing, you said, and I quote, that we're not really geared up to do what we need right now. In fact, you said, and you called it failing. Now it's 5 months later. Where would you rate us now in our efforts? I know my city and other cities have worked diligently trying to respond. Where would you put us now with testing? What do we have to do to continue to get better?
Well, I think you can get a more detailed response from Admiral Giroir, but I'll comment. I think that things are considerably different and improved now than it was several months ago, both for the numbers of tests that have been improved, as well as for the efforts that are going into to expand our capability. In other words, to more prudently have screening testing done in one segment, as well as testing to determine diagnosis and follow up in others. But Dr. Giroir is much better qualified to give you the details of that.
But I would like to now move to vaccines. That's the challenge now. And I recall reading one of your reports on AIDS, and you said, I will never retire until we have a vaccine. We still don't have a vaccine for AIDS. Ebola took 5 years. How realistic is a vaccine? Is it dreaming, or is it a reality? Are the protocols as safe as they possibly could be for, as we've always had for vaccines? Could you give us an honest assessment of where our country is in vaccine development?
Yeah, it's reality, Congresswoman Maloney. I believe it will occur. I think the difference between HIV and coronavirus is so different that I don't think you can compare them, because the body does not make a very good immune response against HIV, so it makes vaccine development very difficult, whereas the body does make a robust immune response against coronavirus, which tells us that I believe that we can get to that goal. I know to some people this seems like it is so fast that there might be compromising of safety and in scientific integrity, and I can tell you that is absolutely not the case. The rapidity with which we're doing it is as a result of very different technologies in getting from the time we recognized this pathogen in the beginning of January to the time we were able to get into a phase one trial, to the time we were able to do phase two, and then, as I mentioned, just this past Monday, we started a phase three. That was not reckless rushing. That was technology and doing things in a way that does not compromise any of the steps. So I believe that it is realistic, as I mentioned in my opening statement, that the early data from the phase one trial shows that this candidate, and I'm sure other candidates, will do it also. This is not the only vaccine. There are more than one. There are about a dozen, five or six, that the federal government is actively involved with, is going into phase three trials over the next few months, as I mentioned, one of which is already in. The response that was induced was really quite favorable. And as I've said often, and I'll repeat it for the record now, there's never a guarantee that you're going to get a safe and effective vaccine. But from everything we've seen now in the animal data, as well as the early human data, we feel cautiously optimistic that we will have a vaccine by the end of this year and as we go into 2021. So I don't think it's dreaming, Congresswoman. I believe it's a reality and will be shown to be a reality.
That's very good news. The second step is, how do we distribute it? And also, reports are that China and Russia are involved in their tests, and that they have advanced tests across the world. They're testing in Brazil, in Indonesia for their vaccines. Should they develop one earlier? Would we manufacture it here? When we develop it, how do we plan to distribute it? We also have to think about the world, because if we don't cure it in the world, then we haven't cured it too.
Right.
So the steps forward after the vaccine's developed.
Sure, there are a couple of questions there. I'll try to answer them quickly, Congresswoman. So the first thing is I do hope that the Chinese and the Russians are actually testing the vaccine before they are administering the vaccine to anyone. Because claims of having a vaccine ready to distribute before you do testing, I think, is problematic at best. We are going very quickly. I do not believe that there will be vaccines so far ahead of us that we will have to depend on other countries to get us vaccines. I believe the program that is being sponsored by us right now and being directed and implemented by us is going at a very rapid speed, prudent but rapid. Now, with regard to distribution, already right now, there are plans, as was mentioned, I believe, by Ranking Member Scalise, that we're taking at risk, financial risk, not safety risk, but financial risk, the development of doses of vaccine right now as we speak, so that they will be ready by the time we do show safety and efficacy, we'll be able to distribute it. And it will be done by a number of mechanisms, the standard mechanism working with the recommendation by the ACIP together with the CDC, now being complemented by recommendations from the National Academy of Medicine, and in collaboration with the Department of Defense and the CDC, working together, it will be distributed.